Hi, this is Stephanie at Beyond Behnke. I want to welcome you to my home today. I want to show you today how to make the famous Behnke bow that everybody always liked to get from our Christmas shop. So let's get started. So what you want to do when you start to make a bow is you need to have some product. You need to have some florist wire, which you can get at any independent garden center or any small business. Just check and ask them. I like to have it already cut in 24-inch lengths because you want a nice bit to tie your bow together and to be able to tie it to your wreath or tie it to your fence post. You need a good pair of scissors. It's very important to have a nice pair of scissors because when you're cutting the ribbon, you want a nice clean cut. You also need a pair of nice needle-nose pliers. What a lot of people don't know is right up here is a little cutter. So you can take your wire, if you need to, say it's on a spool, you can put it right up in there and you cut it. Hopefully. There we go. Clip it right off and there it goes. And the reason you want to use that and not your scissors is because you want a nice sharp edge on your scissors. And this is important. These aren't expensive. These were probably $9 or $10 scissors. And we always bought new ones in our Christmas shop. The reason being, the ladies would get so upset when someone would cut wire with these scissors because you get little nicks in them. You don't want that. So enough about that. So what you do is you want to have your ribbon. I always like to use a good 2.5-inch ribbon. I always use wire ribbon. It's very forgiving. You can make it do what it wants. Typically, you need about 3 yards to do a nice 6-loop bow. And here's one I've already made. I'm going to make an 8-loop bow, and I use about 4 yards when I do that. I just like the way it looks better. 4. And you want to do a nice straight cut for the next time. Once you have your ribbon cut, you always want to have the material facing you. I like this ribbon because it's pretty forgiving because it looks the same on both sides. You can have other ribbon that doesn't, like this ribbon here. It definitely has a back and a front. So you're always going to want to have the front of the ribbon facing you. So I'm going to make my button that goes in the middle of the bow. That will be this part right here. So I'm going to make a loop and I'm going to go like this. And I want to make sure that there's enough so when I wire everything, this doesn't come loose. And I'm going to pinch it and I'm going to twist it. So when I twist it around, that kind of sets it in place. And I got my little bow there. So I usually have to switch my hands. It's just the way I am. Some people can hold it that way. And you want to make your first loop. So at the nursery, we tend to measure. I kind of eyeball it. Problem is when you eyeball something, you get something like this. Everything's all off kilter. This is my bow that I don't care for too much. You got some that are long, some that are short. So measuring is usually good, especially in the beginning. So I'm going to do like a 4-loop bow. I'm going to take it, then we're going to twist it. We're going to pinch it. And then we're going to twist it. So I have the material facing me still. Then I want to do this loop here. We want it to be the same as that loop there. So I'm going to measure again to 4 inches. You can kind of eyeball it and say, well, does that match? You can hold it back like this. And this one looks a little bit taller. So I'm going to just give it a little bit more. And still holding on to everything because that's the most important part of it. So let's try to see this again. Yeah, that's about the same. So from here on, you're going to keep on pinching and twisting. So I'm going to twist it. It's facing me. Make another loop. Just like that. And then you're going to pinch it. And now we're going to work on the top. Twist it. So the material's facing me, the ribbon, the good side, and you're going to make it the same size as this other one. Pinch it, twist it, You want your material facing you again. So now we're getting up to 3 on this side. You want to, it sometimes gets tangled up here. So you're going to pinch it, twist it, and you're going to make another loop up here. At this point, you have your 6 loop bow. You're going to pinch it again. Of course, I said I get 4 yards. I want to make an 8 loop bow. I just like the way they look better. So I got 2 more loops to do. We're going to go like this. Pinch it and twist it. And this will be my last loop. And you can make them even bigger. And a lot of people, when they want to do a tree topper, will go ahead and maybe do like 6 loops on each side. So you have a 12 loop bow. Of course, you need a lot more ribbon. And then you do another 12 loop bow and you tie it all together. And then you have long tails, and that's a good tree topper, but we'll do that another day. So now I've finished my 8 loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm going to take the end of this ribbon, and I'm going to have a nice long tail here. And you want to kind of make it go like this, a little bit ways over here, because you're going to tie all this together. You pinch this top up here, and then you need your wire. So your wire is going to go through the top loop, right like that. And I use my thumb to kind of guide it down. And I'm going to pull it down till it's tight. And I want to have it about equal on both sides. So once it's down and everything is in there, you're going to pull this nice and tight. And you want to twist this. Now, you got fingers like mine, they're getting rather old, where my needle nose pliers, or you can just use, well, these are channel lock pliers, but you can use a pair of regular pliers, and you can give it just another little twist, or you can use your needle nose to give it another little twist, and it just makes it more secure. Don't over twist it or you're going to break your wire. So here you got this big long loop. That's going to be your tail. Now comes the fun part of fluffing. So you start with your center. That's your button, or you call it, or your center. And you're going to take these loops and you're going to pull them apart like this. And as you pull them apart, you can see your bow forming. And the whole thing is, don't be intimidated by this. You have to keep trying. And the wire ribbon is very forgiving. You can kind of shape it how you want it. And you go like this, and you go like this, and you kind of look at it and say, oh, that's a little big. I'm going to tuck a little bit of that down there. And before you know it, you got yourself a nice 8 loop bow. And I'd like to make that button right there. We'll make sure you fluff everything up. So now you got your tails. I'd say I probably made these a little too long, but that's okay. I wanted to have extra to show you the different ways you can do your tails. So one of the things I like the most on doing the tails is, I call them the fish tail. So you're going to have your, this is all hooked together. You're going to fold it like this. And you're going to go right up like this. Cut it like that. And that's called the fish tail. At least that's what we call it. Other people, they're not too fond of that, so they might have them both together. Let me cut this off. I made this long so we can see the different ones. You could just go and make a slant. This is why you want nice sharp scissors, so it would look like that. Some people say, no, we don't like that. And in the Christmas shop, we used to make all sorts of different tails. They might just want flat. But I'm going to go back and do my fishtail. So I'm going to fold it over. You're going to start from the part that you fold over, the wire part. You're going to go right on up. And once again, this is why you want nice sharp scissors. So there's that. So here's my finished bow. I got this wire. Make sure you don't poke yourself. And you're going to decide, what are you going to do with this? Are you going to put it on a wreath? If you have a wreath, you can put it on the top. And have your tails hanging down. You can put it on the bottom. You can bring your, what is great about these wire ribbons is sometimes we'll put this like on the side, and you can clench this up, take a little bit of wire, tie it in, and then maybe put some ornaments or some pine cones or something. The sky's the limit. You need to have fun. And that's pretty much how you make a fantastic, famous Behnke bow. But then what do you do after Christmas? It's time to store your bow. Are you going to just throw it away? Hope not, because, you know, you put a lot of time and effort. What we tell people is take your tissue paper that you have, and you want to stuff these bows just like this. And it's very easy to do. And you stuff them all. I've made tree toppers with like 30 loops, and you stuff each one. And we get them all stuffed, and you can even stuff your middle. You're going to take your wire like this. You can roll, you take your tails, you can roll them up like this. This is for storing, and you're going to take a paper clip, clip that together. And then you're going to take a bag, a clear bag or a garbage bag or whatever, put your bow down in it, hang it upside down. If you have a hook in your basement or attic, you can just hook it over like that. You want to have it in a bag so the critters don't get into it. You can also just put it into your closet on a hanger, but just don't shove clothes next to it. You want to make sure that your ribbon stays nice and fresh. A lot of people will take a ribbon like this and they'll put it right into a box, so there's nothing on top of it crushing it. And then next year you just pull out your tissue paper. That would make your ribbon last a couple years. I hope you had as much fun watching me make this bow as I did doing it. And I really appreciate you taking the time to watch it. Please tag me at hashtag Beyond Behnkes and just share it with your friends. Till next time, this is Stephanie at Beyond Behnkes.